Va bene.
Costa Rica, mamá, Costa Rica.
El mejor café del mundo.
Costa Rica, pura vida. ¡Claro, pide!
Oh,
rossa.
La Jacinta è rappresentata con l'agnello. La Lucia mi domanda perché la porti, perché portate l'agnello, mi voglio fare come Gesù.
Caros peregrinos, dentro de breves momentos, a procissão de entrada introduz-nos na celebração da Santa Missa. Celebramos a Missa da Solenidade de Nossa Senhora de Fátima, presidida por Sua Santidade, Papa Francisco, que, entretanto, se irá dirigir para o altar, partindo da Basílica de Nossa Senhora do Rosário. Somos todos convidados a participar com fé e recolhimento, evitando levantar cartazes e bandeiras durante a celebração. Vamos confiantes ao trono da graça e alcançaremos misericórdia. Entretanto, iremos cantar de pé.
Tra pochi istanti, la processione d'ingresso ci introdurrà nella celebrazione della Santa Messa. Siamo tutti invitati a partecipare con fede e raccoglimento, evitando di innalzare cartelli e sventolare bandiere.
The entrance procession of the Eucharistic celebration is about to commence. You are invited to participate with faith and with recollection in Holy Mass and refrain from raising banners or waving flags.
Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. This is Vatican Radio bringing you live from the Marian Sanctuary of Fatima in Portugal, the Holy Mass of Pope Francis, in commemoration of the 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary in Fatima, Portugal. I'm Robin Gomes here in the studio of Vatican Radio, and together with me is also Sister Carmelan AC. Our Lady appeared six times between May 13th and October 13th, 1917, to three shepherd children, Lucia dos Santos and her cousins Francisco and Jacinta Marto, in the place called Covadiria, where today stands the Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary in Fatima. Less than 2 years after the apparitions, Francisco died at the age of 10, and his sister Jacinta the following year at the age of 9, both victims of an influenza pandemic. On the other hand, their cousin Lucia, who later became a disguised Carmelite nun, died in 2005 in Coimbra, Portugal, at the age of 97. Francisco and Jacinta were beatified by St. John Paul II on May the 13th, 2000. And today, at this very Mass, at the start of the Fatima Centenary Mass by Pope Francis, the Pope will declare Francisco and Jacinta saints. And they are going to be the youngest ever non-martyr saints of the Church, with Jacinta being the youngest. And this live coverage is linked up with several televisions and radio stations across the world. And they are CBS News, Shalom World TV, Radio Maria, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Net TV, Catholic TV. And we are also streaming live on the Vatican's YouTube channel. Hello to all of you out there, our listeners and our viewers following this live coverage from the Shrine of Fatima. During the course of this Mass, we shall bring you translations of the texts and prayers, and of course, the Holy Father's homily at the Mass.
A festa que celebramos e cantamos com mais entusiasmo. Em festa, dizemos todos:
Aleluia!
Aleluia! Today's liturgy has three parts. As said earlier, we have the canonization ceremony at the start, and then the Mass proper. And at the end of the Mass, there will be the adoration of the Blessed Sacrament with the blessing of the sick.
Vamos confiantes ao trono da graça e alcançaremos misericórdia.
Cantamos.
Vamos confiantes ao trono da graça e alcançaremos misericórdia.
Graça e misericórdia são de facto as palavras que encerram o mistério de Fátima. O mistério de Fátima é o Senhor Deus encarnado na humanidade. A maior bênção que podemos esperar para a nossa vida, a graça e a misericórdia derramada no nosso cotidiano. É por isso que cantamos, vamos confiantes ao trono da graça e alcançaremos misericórdia. Cantamos com alegria.
Vamos confiantes ao trono.
E assim diremos, como o salmista, que o coração que transportamos, todo o nosso ser vibra com uma ideia feliz. Queremos, por isso, dedicar ao Rei a nossa vida, a nossa existência, todo o nosso viver. Cantamos com alegria, irmãos peregrinos.
Vamos confiantes ao mundo.
The
entire square or the churchyard in front of the Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary is packed capacity, waiting for the Pope, and as they're waiting, they are singing hymns in preparation for this Mass, the centenary Mass, celebrating 100 years of the apparitions of Our Lady to the three children, Lucia, Francisco, and Jacinta. Pope Francis is here for the first time, and as a Pope, and it is his 19th foreign visit outside Italy. And earlier popes have also been there at Fatima. This visit of Pope Francis is sixth in line, or the seventh in line. The first visit was by Pope Paul VI in 1967, which was the 50th anniversary of the apparitions of Fatima. And St. John Paul had been to Fatima three times, in 1982, 1991, and 2000. 1982 was the visit of Pope John Paul there, after a year after, the following year after there was an assassination attempt on his life on May the 13th, exactly this day, 1981. And he had gone there to thank Our Lady, who he said, with her hand, diverted the bullet that was aimed at his heart. And that was in thanksgiving for saving his life. And the next visit was in 1991. And the last visit of Pope John Paul was in the year 2000, during which he declared Francisco and Jacinta blessed. He had gone there to beatify them. And then later on, we have Pope Benedict XVI visiting Fatima in 2010 on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of the beatification of Francisco and Jacinta. And now Pope Francis is here. This is the sixth visit, sorry, not the seventh, the sixth visit. And with this visit, with this canonization today, Francisco and Jacinta will be the youngest child saints non-martyred in the history of the Catholic Church. And it was here 36 years ago that Pope John Paul, it was in the Vatican, St. Peter's Square, that there was an assassination attempt on Pope John Paul that wounded him, and he was saved, he says, by the hand of the Virgin Mary that diverted the bullet away from his heart. Once more, for those who have tuned in late, this is Vatican Radio bringing you live from the Marian Sanctuary of Fatima in Portugal, the Holy Mass of Pope Francis in commemoration of the 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary in Fatima here, Portugal. He will also canonize the two children to whom Our Lady appeared, Francisco and Jacinta, the youngest ever non-martyr child saints of the Church. Welcome to all our listeners and viewers who are linked up with the several radio televisions and radio stations, namely CBS News, Shalom World TV, Radio Maria, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Net TV, Catholic TV, and we are also streaming live on the Vatican's YouTube channel. Welcome to the commemoration of the 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mass of the commemoration of the 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary in Fatima, in Portugal. This is Pope Francis's first visit as Pope to Fatima, and it is his 19th foreign visit outside of Italy. And the motto of this pastoral visit, of this pilgrimage he calls it, is with Mary, pilgrim in hope and in peace. We are here in the sanctuary, in the shrine of Our Lady of Fatima, in front of the sanctuary of the Our Lady of the Holy Rosary.
A paz esteja convosco.
Pope Francis has just started the Mass with the sign of the cross. And I said earlier, the first part of the Mass is dedicated to the canonization ceremony of Jacinta and Francisco. And the crowd now is singing Veni Santo Spirito. Veni Creator Spiritus.
Thank you.
Santo Padre pede a Santa Mãe Igreja que Vossa Santidade inscreva os Beatos Francisco Marto e Jacinta Marto no catálogo dos santos e, como tais, sejam invocados por todos os cristãos.
Bishop Antonio Marto of Leiria Fatima, accompanied by the postulator of the cause of Jacinta and Francisco, Sister Angela Coelho, requested the Pope to canonize Francisco and Jacinta. Holy Mother, they said, the Bishop Antonio Marto said, Most Holy Father, Holy Mother,
Francisco Marto e Jacinta Marto, são os mais novos.
Most Holy Father, Holy Mother Church requests Your Holiness to enroll Blessed Francisco Marto and Jacinta among the saints, that they may be invoked as such by all the Christian faithful. And now, a brief biography of both the shepherd children, Francisco and Jacinta, is being narrated.
Jacinta Marto nasceu em 5 de março de 1910, tendo sido batizada no dia 19 desse mês, também na igreja paroquial de Fátima. Cresceram num ambiente familiar e social modesto, profundamente cristão. A sua educação cristã, simples mas sólida, teve como seus principais agentes seus pais, que foram para eles um exemplo de fé comprometida, de respeito por todos, de caridade para com os pobres e os necessitados. Ainda muito novos, começaram a pastorear o rebanho da família. Francisco tinha 8 anos e Jacinta 6. Passavam grande parte dos dias na tarefa de acompanhar as ovelhas, juntamente com a sua prima Lúcia. Em 1916, na primavera, no verão e no outono, veem o Anjo da Paz. Entre maio e outubro de 1917, em cada dia 13, em agosto no dia 19, foram visitados pela Virgem Maria, a Senhora do Rosário. Na primeira aparição, em 13 de maio de 1917, a Santíssima Virgem fez-lhes um convite. Quereis oferecer-vos a Deus? Com sua prima Lúcia responderam, sim, queremos. A partir dessa data, viveram as suas vidas entregues a Deus e aos seus desígnios de misericórdia. Do perfil de Francisco, sobressai o seu jeito pacífico e sereno. A partir das aparições do Anjo e de Nossa Senhora, desenvolverá um estilo de vida caracterizado pela contemplação e pela adoração. Sempre que podia, refugiava-se num lugar isolado para rezar. Frequentemente passava longas horas no silêncio da igreja paroquial, junto ao sacrário, para fazer companhia a Jesus escondido. Na sua intimidade com Deus, Francisco entrevê um Deus triste face aos sofrimentos do mundo. Sofre com ele e deseja consolá-lo. Sendo o mais contemplativo dos três videntes, a sua vida de oração alimenta-se da escuta atenta do silêncio em que Deus fala. Deixa-se habitar pela presença indizível de Deus. Eu sentia que Deus estava em mim, mas não sabia como era, diz. E é a partir dessa presença que acolhe os outros na oração. Em outubro de 1918, adoece, vítima da epidemia broncopneumónica. No dia 2 de abril de 1919, confessa-se e no dia 3 de abril recebe o beático. No dia seguinte, em 4 de abril, pelas 22 horas, morre serenamente em sua casa, rodeado pelos seus familiares. foi sepultado no cemitério de Fátima em 5 de abril de 1919. Em 13 de março de 1952, os seus restos mortais foram trasladados para a Basílica de Nossa Senhora do Rosário, no Santuário de Fátima. Jacinta tinha um caráter carinhoso e expansivo. Tocada pelas aparições do anjo e da mãe de Deus, deixou-se impressionar sobretudo pelo sofrimento dos pobres pecadores e pela missão e sofrimento do Santo Padre. De facto, após esses encontros com o céu, vive completamente esquecida de si, oferecendo orações e sacrifícios para o bem de quantos sofrem. Sua espiritualidade é caracterizada pela entrega generosa de si, como um dom para os demais. Todos os pequenos gestos do seu dia, inclusive as contrariedades na doença, eram motivo de oferta a Deus pela conversão dos pecadores e pelo Santo Padre. Partilhava a sua merenda com os pobres, oferecendo o jejum em sacrifício como sinal da sua disponibilidade para ser totalmente de Deus. Característica fundamental da sua espiritualidade era a compaixão, especificamente pelos que sofriam e pelos que viviam afastados de Deus. No final do ano de 1918, Jacinta adoece com a epidemia broncopneumónica. Em janeiro de 1920, é levada para Lisboa para ser tratada no Hospital Dona Estefânia. Na noite de 20 de fevereiro, às 22h30, morre sozinha. É sepultada em 24 de fevereiro no cemitério de Ourém. Em 12 de setembro de 1935, os seus restos mortais são trasladados para o cemitério de Fátima e em 1 de maio de 1951 para a Basílica de Nossa Senhora do Rosário no Santuário de Fátima. Os traços de espiritualidade dos dois irmãos assumem uma vocação inseparavelmente contemplativa e compassiva que os leva a ser espelho da luz de Deus na prática das boas obras. Francisco e Jacinta Marto foram beatificados por São João Paulo II em Fátima em 13 de maio de 2000. Recentemente, Vossa Santidade autorizou que a Congregação para as Causas dos Santos promulgasse o decreto do milagre
Bishop
atribuído...
Antonio Marto of Leiria Fátima is reading the biography of both Francisco and Jacinta, who are going to be canonized by Pope Francis in a little while from now. Francisco was born on the 11th of June 1908 in Aljustrel, and he died a holy death on the 4th of April 1919. He was very sensible and contemplative, and very sensible to the feelings of others, sufferings of others, and all his spirituality was geared to penitence and penance to console the Lord. Jacinta was born also in Aljustrel on the 11th of March 1910 and died a holy death on 20th February 1920 after a long protracted sickness. And both these children are buried in the sanctuary of Our Lady of Her Holy Rosary. Now the Pope is pronouncing the formula of the canonization of Jacinta and Francisco.
Para que, por intercessão da bem-aventurada Virgem Maria e de todos os santos, sustente com a sua graça o ato solene que estamos para realizar.
That's the prayer of, that's the invitation of Pope Francis to the people gathered there. Let us lift up our prayers to God, the Father Almighty, through Jesus Christ, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, he may sustain with his grace the act which we now solemnly undertake. And now the congregation and the choir are singing the Litany of the Saints, because in a little while, Jacinta and Francisco will be among them. For those who have tuned in late, this is Vatican Radio bringing you live from the Marian Sanctuary of Fatima in Portugal, the Holy Mass of Pope Francis in commemoration of the 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary here. And during this Mass, he is going to beatify the two children, Francisco and Jacinta Marto, during this Mass. Pope has just started his Mass, and we are in the first part of the canonization ceremony. The congregation as well as the choir singing the Litany of the Saints.
San João Maria, Vianney. Santa Teresa de Jesus,
rogai por nós.
Santa Beatriz da Silva,
rogai por nós.
Todos os santos e santas de Deus,
that cleared the way for Jacinta and Francisco to canonization is regarding a Brazilian boy who recovered at a lightning speed after a serious fall in his home in Brazil. And for the first time, the secret of this miracle was revealed at a press conference by the boy's father and mother here in Fatima. In March 2013, Lucas Batista, then 5 years old, fell more than 6 meters from a window and smashed his skull. And he was miraculously cured.
As rezamos do vosso povo, para que o ato que realizamos no desempenho do nosso serviço vos seja agradável e sirva para incremento da vossa igreja. Por Cristo, Senhor nosso.
We ask you, Lord, to graciously accept the prayers of your people, that our service may be pleasing to you and help contribute to the growth of your church, the Pope prayed. And now the solemn formula of the canonization.
In ombra da Santissima Trinidade, per esaltação da fé católica e incremento da via cristã, com a autoridade de nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo, dos santos apóstolos Pedro e Paulo e nós, depois de termos longamente referido, implorando várias vezes o auxílio divino, e ouvido o parecer de muitos irmãos nossos no episcopado, declaramos e definimos como santos os beatos Francisco Marto e Jacinta Marto.
For the honor of the Blessed Trinity, the exaltation of the Catholic faith, and the increase of the Christian life by the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ and of the Holy Apostles Peter and Paul and our own, after due deliberation and frequent prayer for divine assistance, And having sought the counsel of many of our brother bishops, we declare and define Blessed Francisco Marto and Jacinta Marto to be saints, the Pope said in his formula. And we enroll them among the saints, decreeing that they be venerated as such by the whole Church. And with that, we have Francisco and Jacinta, the youngest child saints non-martyred of the Catholic Church. And their feast is on February the 20th. Loud cheers going on there for the youngest child saints non-martyred here, that the Pope pronounced them saints here in the basilica, in the shrine, at the shrine of Our Lady of Fatima.
Do fundo do coração, a proclamação feita por Vossa Santidade, e peço humildemente se digna ordenar que seja redigida a carta apostólica relativa à canonização efetuada.
Assim ordenamos.
Bishop Antonios Marto of Leiria Fatima just thanked the Pope for canonizing Francisco and Jacinta. And now Sister Angela Coelho, who has been the postulator for the cause of Francisco and Jacinta, greeting the Pope, meeting the Pope there alongside Bishop Antonio Marto. And with that, we come to the conclusion of the first part, the canonization ceremony, and now the Mass of the 100 years of the apparitions of Our Blessed Lady to the three children of Fatima.
Oh,
canonization of Francisco and Jacinta, a miracle was needed. And that miracle nobody knew so far. Only on Thursday, 11th of May, was it revealed here in Fatima at a press conference by the parents of a child who was miraculously cured. João Batista and Lucila Yuri spoke to the press, to the media, regarding this miracle of their son, Lucas Batista. It was on March 2013, Lucas, then 5 years old, fell more than 6 meters from a window and smashed his skull while he was playing with his little sister. He was transferred to hospital, though an hour or so late, where he arrived in a very serious condition and he was in coma. And before that, while being transported to the hospital, his heart stopped twice and then he needed urgent operation.
Deus de infinita bondade, que nos estes amai do vosso filho como nos amai, concedei-nos que, seguindo os seus ensinamentos e com espírito de verdadeira penitência e oração, trabalhemos generosamente pela salvação do mundo e pela dilatação do reino de Cristo. Ele que é Deus convosco na unidade do Espírito Santo.
Leitura do Apocalipse de São João. O templo de Deus abriu-se no céu e a Arca da Aliança foi vista no seu templo.
The first reading is taken from the book of Revelations.
Uma mulher vestida de sol.
Then God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of His covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with a moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth, to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and His throne. And the woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God and the authority of His anointed." The word of the Lord.
responsorial psalm after the first reading is taken from Psalm 44. Listen and bow before your Lord. Continuing our story of the 5-year-old boy who was miraculously cured through the intercession of Jacinta and Francisco, Lucas Batista of Brazil. He fell more than 6 meters and smashed his skull, and he was taken to the hospital where before that he suffered almost 2 heart attacks. And doctor said that he had little chance of pulling through, and even if he did, he would be in a vegetative state. But the family, João Batista and his wife Lucila Yuri, had great devotion to Our Lady of Fatima, and contacting members of the Carmelites, a Catholic religious order, the little boy's family prayed to the 2 children, Jacinta and Francisco. And 2 days later, Lucas woke up. He was doing well, and he started to talk, Batista told the reporters. He left hospital 12 days later. He has completely recovered. He has no after effects, his father told the press people. We thank God for Lucas's recovery, and we know with all the faith in our heart that he recovered thanks to a miracle brought about by the small shepherds, Francisco and Jacinta, João Batista said at the press conference. Even the doctors, and including the non-believers, were not able to explain this recovery, according to João.
Estabelecê-los, Pai.
The entire Mass readings are in Portuguese, the local language.
The second reading is taken from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. Brothers, just as through one person sin entered the world, and through sin death, and thus death came to all, in as much as all sinned. For if by the transgression of one person death came to reign through that one, how much more will those who receive the abundance of grace and of the gift of justification come to reign in life through the one person, Jesus Christ? For certainly, just as through one transgression condemnation came upon all, so through one righteous act, acquittal and life came to all. In conclusion, just as through the transgression of one man, Adam, condemnation came upon all, so through righteous act of one man, Jesus Christ, acquittal and life came to all. For just as through the disobedience of one person the many were made sinners, so through the obedience of one the many will be made righteous. The word of the Lord. The deacon is approaching the lectern from where he will read the gospel of this canonization Mass and the Mass also of the 100 years of the Fatima apparitions.
Here de nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo, segundo São João.
Glória a vós, Senhor.
And today's gospel is from St. John.
Naquele tempo, estavam junto à cruz de Jesus sua mãe, a irmã de sua mãe.
At that time, standing by the cross of Jesus, were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas.
Ao ver sua mãe, o discípulo predileto,
and Mary of Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple there whom he loved, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son."
O discípulo recebeu-a em sua casa. Palavra da salvação.
Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his home. With the reading of the Gospel over, we await the homily of Pope Francis.
Apareceu no céu una mulher revestida de sol, a testa ovidente de Patmos no Apocalipse, anotando ainda que ela estava para ser mãe. Depois, vimos no Evangelho Jesus dizer ao discípulo, "Eis a tua mãe."
There appeared in heaven a woman clothed with the sun. So the seer of Patmos tells us in the book of Revelation, adding that she was about to give birth to a son. Then in the Gospel we hear Jesus say to his disciple, "Here is your mother." We have a mother. So beautiful a lady, as the seers of Fatima said to one another as they returned home on that blessed day of 13th May 100 years ago. That evening, Jacinta could not restrain herself and told the secret to her mother. Today I saw Our Lady.
Estes non a vida.
They had seen the Mother of Heaven. Many others sought to share that vision, but they did not see her. The Virgin Mother did not come here so that we could see her. We will have all eternity for that, provided, of course, that we go to heaven.
Tanta veces proposta e imposta sem Deus e profanando Deus nas suas criaturas, veio lembrar-nos a luz de Deus.
Our Lady foretold and warned us about a way of life that is godless and indeed profanes God in His creatures. Such a life, Pope Francis says, frequently proposed and imposed risks leading to hell.
Ficaban dentro da luz de Deus que irradiava de Nossa Senhora.
Mary came to remind us that God's light dwells within us and protects us, for as we heard in the first reading, the child of the woman was snatched away and taken to God. In Lucia's account, the three chosen children found themselves surrounded by God's light as it radiated from Our Lady.
Aqui, como em qualquer outro lugar da terra, quando nos refugiamos sob a proteção da Virgem Mãe, para lhe pedir, como ensina...
She enveloped them in the mantle of light that God had given her. According to the belief and experience of many pilgrims, if not of all, Fatima is more than anything this mantle of light that protects us here, as in almost no other place on earth. We need but take refuge under the protection of the Virgin Mary and to ask her, as the Salve Regina teaches us, show unto us Jesus.
Vivamos da esperança que assenta em Jesus, pois, como ouvíamos na segunda leitura, aqueles que recebem com abundância a graça e o dom da justiça reinarão na vida por meio de só Jesus Cristo. Quando Jesus subiu ao céu, levou para junto do país celeste a nossa humanidade, que tinha assumido no seio da Virgem Mãe e nunca mais alargará. Como uma âncora,
we have a mother. Clinging to her like children, we live in the hope that rests on Jesus. As we heard in the second reading, those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness exercise dominion in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. When Jesus ascended to heaven, He brought to the Heavenly Father our humanity, which He assumed in the womb of the Virgin Mary and will never forsake. Like an anchor, let us fix our hope on that humanity seated in heaven at the right hand of the Father. May this hope guide our lives. It is a hope that sustains us always to our dying breath. Confirmed in this hope, we have gathered here to give thanks for the countless graces bestowed over these past 100 years, all of them passed beneath the mantle of light that Our Lady has spread over the four corners of the earth, beginning with this land of Portugal, so rich in hope. We can take as our examples Saint Francisco and Saint Jacinta, whom the Virgin Mary introduced into the immense ocean of God's light and taught to adore Him. That was the sumus of their strength in overcoming opposition and suffering. God's presence became constant in their lives, as is evident from their insistent prayers for sinners and their desire to remain ever near the hidden Jesus in the tabernacle.
Nas suas memórias, a irmã Lucia dá a palavra a Jacinta, que beneficiará de uma visão. Não vês tanta estrada, tantos caminhos e campos cheios de gente a chorar com fome e não tem nada para comer?
In her memoirs, Sister Lucia quotes Jacinta, who had just been granted a vision. Do you not see all those streets, all those paths and fields full of people crying out for food, yet have nothing to eat? And the Holy Father in a church praying before the Immaculate Heart of Mary? And all those people praying with him? Thank you, brothers and sisters, for being here with me. I could not fail to come here to venerate the Virgin Mary and to entrust her to all her sons and daughters. Under her mantle, they are not lost. From her embrace will come the hope and the peace that they require, and that I implore for all my brothers and sisters in baptism and in our human family, especially the sick and the disabled, prisoners and the unemployed, the poor and the abandoned. Dear brothers and sisters, let us pray to God with a hope that others will hear us, and let us speak to others with a certainty that God will help us.
Queridos irmãos, rezamos a Deus com a esperança de que nos escutem os homens. E dirigimos-nos aos homens com a certeza de que nos vale Deus. Pois Ele... Pois Ele criou-nos como uma esperança para os outros. Uma esperança real e realizável.
Indeed, God created us to be a source of hope for others, a true and attainable hope in accordance with each person's state of life. In asking and demanding of each of us the fulfillment of the duties of our proper state, God effects a general mobilization against the indifference that chills the heart and worsens our myopia. We do not want to be a stillborn hope. Life can survive only because of the generosity of other lives. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. The Lord, who always goes before us, said this and did this. Whenever we experience the cross, He has already experienced it before us. We do not mount the cross to find Jesus. Instead, it was He who, in His self-abasement, descended even to the cross in order to find us, to dispel the darkness of evil within us, and to bring us back to the light. With Mary's protection, may we be, for our world, sentinels of the dawn, contemplating the true face of Jesus the Savior, resplendent at Easter. Thus, may we rediscover the young and beautiful face of the Church, which shines forth when she is missionary, welcoming, free, faithful, poor in means, and rich in love.
Meditemos alguns momentos em silêncio.
Meditemos brevemente in silenzio. Rimaniamo alcuni istanti a meditare in silenzio. Let us reflect in silence for some brief moments.
For those who have tuned in late, this is Vatican Radio bringing you live from the Marian Sanctuary of Fatima in Portugal, the Holy Mass of Pope Francis in commemoration of 100 years of the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary to Lucia dos Santos and today Saint Francisco and Saint Jacinta, the last two whom he canonized today at this Mass. At this very moment, the Mass, the Credo is being sung by the choir and joined in by the people. This is Pope Francis's first visit to Fatima as Pope, and he is the fourth Pope to visit this shrine after Pope Paul VI, Pope John Paul II, who visited it three times, Pope Benedict, and now Pope Francis.
Irmãos e irmãs, neste lugar sagrado onde a Santíssima Virgem apareceu, elevemos as nossas orações a Deus Pai.
Brothers and sisters, in this sacred place where the Blessed Virgin appeared, let us raise our prayers to God the Almighty Father, and through the intercession of the glorious Virgin Mary, let us invoke the Divine Mercy.
Pelo Santo Padre Francisco, hoje aqui presente, e por todos os pastores da Igreja, para que, iluminados pelo Espírito de Cristo ressuscitado, sejam para todos sinal do amor e
The first prayer of the faithful is for the Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all the pastors of the Church throughout the world, that they may be enlightened by the Spirit of the risen Christ, and may be to all a sign of the love and tenderness of God, who casts down the mighty and exalts the lowly.
Per tutta l'umanità e i suoi governanti, perché l'impegno per la cura della casa comune riunisca tutti nella costruzione.
The second prayer of the faithful is in Italian for the entire humanity and its rulers, so that the commitment for the care of our common home may unite all to build a world that is more brotherly, where everyone feels welcome and respected in his or her cultural and religious differences.
For all the children and for their families, that the example of Saints Francisco and Jacinta inspire them to discover the meaning of life and the value of prayer and penance, and that they see their rights always respected. Oremos.
Malades et tous ceux qui, chaque jour, expérimentent le mystère de la souffrance, pour que la présence de Marie auprès de la croix leur porte du réconfort, de la consolation et de l'espérance. Oremus.
The next prayer of the faithful in French was for the sick and all those who every day experience the mystery of suffering, so that the presence of Mary at the cross may bring them comfort, consolation and hope.
I za tych, którzy polecali się naszej modlitwie i wstawiennictwu Najświętszej Maryi Panny, aby jej niepokalane serce było zawsze naszą ucieczką i drogą.
The next intention is in Polish for all of us gathered here and for those who commend ourselves to our prayer and intercession with Our Lady, so that her Immaculate Heart will always be the refuge and the path that leads to God.
المهجرين من أجل الفقراء واللاجئين حتى أنه بشفاعة مريم التي تعرف بكل آلامهم يشعرون بحسن استقبال جميع الذين يقدمون لهم الكرامة وأسبابا للرجاء أوريموس.
And the last prayer intention in Arabic was for the sick and for those who, day to day, closely experience the mystery of suffering, that the presence of Mary at the cross give them comfort, consolation, and hope.
Ouvi a nossa oração e aumentai nostra fé. Per nosso Signor Gesù Cristo, vostro Figlio.
And the concluding prayer of the Pope at the end of the prayer of the faithful. Lord Jesus, that in this marvelous sacrament you have left us the memorial of your passion, grant us the grace to venerate the mysteries of your body and blood in a way that we may continually feel the fruits of your redemption. Probably the family that just met the Pope is that of João Baptista, Lucila Yuri, and the miracle boy, Lucas Batista, who was miraculously cured after he had that tragic fall and his skull was smashed.
Thank you.
As we have said, this is the 19th foreign pastoral visit of Pope Francis, and it is to Fatima. He is the fourth pope to visit Fatima, and there have been so far 6 visits, including this, to Fatima by the popes. The first one, Pope Paul VI, in 1976, and then John Paul made 3 visits there, and Benedict 1 in 2010, and Pope Francis now here in 2017, 50 years after the Pope Paul VI landed there on the same day.
Que o meu vosso sacrifício seja aceite por Deus Pai Todo-Poderoso. Por este sacrifício de reconciliação e de louvor que vos oferecemos na festa da Virgem Santa Maria, perdonai benignamente, Senhor, os nossos pecados e orientai os nossos corações no caminho da santidade e da paz. Por nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo, vosso Filho, que Deus convosco na unidade do Espírito Santo. O Senhor esteja convosco. Corações ao alto. Demos graças ao Senhor, nosso Deus. Senhor Pai Santo, Deus eterno e onipotente, é verdadeiramente nosso dever e nossa salvação celebrar o vosso poder admirável na perfeição dos santos e exaltar a vossa bondade na solenidade da Virgem Santa Maria, inspirando-nos no seu cântico de louvor. Vós fizestes maravilhas a favor de todos os povos e manifestastes de geração em geração a vossa misericórdia quando olhastes para a humildade da vossa serva e por ela nos destes o Salvador do mundo, Jesus Cristo, nosso Senhor. Por ele, com a multidão dos anjos que adoram a vossa majestade e se alegram eternamente na vossa presença, proclamamos a vossa glória cantando numa só voz.
Thank you.
Señor, sois verdaderamente santo. Y todas las criaturas cantan vuestros louvores, porque dais a vida y santificáis todas las cosas por Jesus Cristo, vuestro Hijo, nuestro Señor, con el poder del Espíritu Santo. Y no cesáis de reunir para vos un pueblo que, da un extremo al otro de la tierra, vos ofrece una oblación pura. Humildemente vos suplicamos, Señor, santificai por el Espíritu Santo estos dones que vos presentamos para que se conviertan en el cuerpo y sangre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, vuestro Hijo, que nos mandó celebrar estos misterios. La noche que él iba a ser entregue, tomó el pan y, dando gracias, abençoó, partió y dio a sus discípulos diciendo: tomai todos y comei, esto es o meu cuerpo que será entregue por vos. De igual modo, no fin de ceia, tomó el cálice y, dando gracias, abençoó y dio a sus discípulos, diciendo: tomai todos y bebei. Este es el cálice de mi sangre, o sangre de la nueva y eterna alianza, que será derramado por vos y por todos para remisión de los pecados. Haced esto en memoria de mí.
Mistério da fé.
Anunciamos, Senhor, a vossa morte. Proclamamos a vossa ressurreição. Vinde, Senhor Jesus.
Celebrando agora, Senhor, o memorial da paixão redentora do vosso Filho, da sua admirável ressurreição e ascensão aos céus, esperando a sua vinda gloriosa, nós vos oferecemos, em ação de graças, este sacrifício vivo e santo. Orai benignamente para a oblação da vossa Igreja. Vede nella vittima che nos riconciliò convosco e facei che, alimentandonos do corpo e sangue de vosso Figlio, cheios do seu Espírito Santo, sejamos in Cristo un suo corpo e un suo Espírito.
O Espírito Santo faça de nós uma ofrenda permanente, a fim de alcançarmos a herança eterna em companhia dos vossos eleitos. com a Virgem Santa Maria, Mãe de Deus, São José, seu esposo, os bem-aventurados apóstolos e gloriosos mártires, São Francisco e Santa Jacinta, e todos os santos, por cuja intercessão esperamos sempre o vosso auxílio.
Por este sacrifício de reconciliação, dai, Senhor, a salvação e a paz ao mundo inteiro. Confirmai a vossa Igreja na fé e na caridade ao longo da sua peregrinação na Terra, com o vosso servo, o Papa Francisco, o nosso Bispo António e todos os bispos e ministros sagrados e todo o povo por vós redimido. Atendei benignamente às preces desta família que vos dignaste reunir na vossa presença. Reconduzi a vós, Pai de Misericórdia, todos os vossos filhos dispersos. Lembrai-vos dos nossos irmãos defuntos e de todos os que morreram na vossa amizade. Acolhei-os com bondade no vosso reino, onde também nós esperamos ser recebidos para vivermos com eles eternamente na vossa glória, por Jesus Cristo, nosso Senhor. Por ele, concedeis ao mundo todos os bens.
Por Cristo, com Cristo, em Cristo, a vós, Deus Pai Todo-Poderoso, na unidade do Espírito Santo, toda a honra e toda a glória, agora e para sempre.
Porque nos amamos e somos filhos de Deus, cantemos confiantes a oração que o Senhor nos ensinou. Senhor, e dai ao mundo a paz em nossos dias, para que, ajudados pela vossa misericórdia, sejamos sempre livres do pecado e de toda a perturbação, enquanto esperamos a vinda gloriosa de Jesus Cristo, nosso Salvador. Señor Jesucristo, que dicestes a vossos apóstolos, deixo vossa paz, dou vos a minha paz. Não olheis a nossos pecados, mas a fé da vossa Igreja, e dai-lhe a união e a paz, segundo a vossa vontade. Vós que sois Deus, como Pai, na unidade do Espírito Santo.
Amém.
A paz do Senhor esteja sempre convosco.
O amor de Cristo nos uniu.
Saudai-vos na paz de Cristo.
Felices os convidados para a ceia ao Senhor. Eis o Cordeiro de Deus que tira o pecado do mundo.
Francis himself has a special devotion to Our Lady of Fatima. In his first Angelus address after being elected Pope, he mentioned a statue of Our Lady of Fatima that came to Buenos Aires on pilgrimage shortly after he became a bishop there in 1992. Then in 2013, 2 months after his election, Pope Francis asked the Patriarch of Lisbon to consecrate his papacy to Our Lady of Fatima, and Cardinal Policarpo did so on May 13, 2013. On the anniversary of the last Fatima apparition, October 13, 2013, during the Marian Day of the Year of Faith, Pope Francis entrusted the world to Our Lady of Fatima.
Well, the central message of Our Lady to the three children of Fatima is one of conversion, of penance and prayer at the heart of Mary. And Mary appeared to them 6 times, starting May the 13th, 1917. And in the first apparition itself, Mary asked them to come to that place which is called Cova da Iria, where the sanctuary, where the Basilica of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary is built. And the chapel, the little chapel which they built, is actually the place where Our Lady appeared to them. And on May 13th, 1917, Our Lady didn't give her who she was, but she simply said, "I am from heaven," and that she would reveal her identity later. She asked them to come to that very spot for the next 6 months on the same day and to pray the rosary in order to obtain peace for the world and the end of World War I, which was raging then. And then again on June the 13th, the following month, the lady appeared to them, to Francisco, Jacinta, and Lucia, and said that Jacinta and Francisco would be in heaven soon, and that Lucia would remain a little longer on earth to establish the devotion to the Immaculate Heart. And in July 13th, she said that she would reveal her identity on the last day, that is in October 13th, and that she would perform a miracle. And she continued telling the children to make sacrifices for sinners. And it was on July the 13th that she revealed three secrets to the children. Two of the secrets were not made public until 1941. And the third secret, written down by Sister Lucia and sent to the Vatican, was released only in the year 2000. And on August 13th, they were unable to go to Cova di Iria because the authorities had prevented them, but they made it on August the 19th. And again, the lady said she would perform a miracle on the last day, on 13th of October, and asked that those people, pilgrims who came with them, gather some money and build a chapel on the site of the apparitions. And 13th September, the lady asked them to continue to pray the rosary to obtain the end of World War I, and said that Jesus, Saint Joseph, and Our Lady of Sorrows and Our Lady of Carmel would appear on the last day, that is October the 13th. And on the last day, October the 13th, a lot of people came. The whole area was filled with people and faithful believers and unbelievers alike. And on the last day, the lady revealed her identity, the Lady of the Rosary, and said the war would end soon and soldiers would return home. And she asked that people cease to offend God. And she opened her hand, which reflected the light towards the sun. And then occurred what is called the miracle of the sun. The sun appeared to dance and spin and change colors. And the children saw the promised figures of Jesus, Saint Joseph, and Mary. 13 years after Mary's final apparition at Fatima, the Bishop of Leiria declared the visions of the three shepherd children worthy of belief and allowed the veneration of Our Lady of Fatima. However, the bishop did not recognize the so-called dancing sun, the miracle of the dancing sun. Now, what are these three secrets? The first secret involved a vision of hell in which the children saw a sea of fire, with demons and human souls shrieking in pain and despair. And Sister Lucia, who lived the longest till the age of 97 and died in the year 2005, said people nearby who had begun gathering around the children on the 13th of the month heard her cry out during the frightening revelation. The second secret was that while World War I would come to an end, a worse one would break out soon after that if people continued offending God. The children were told that calamity would be prevented if Russia were consecrated to the Immaculate Heart. And the third and the final secret was published 83 years after the Fatima apparitions. And that was a vision of a so-called bishop dressed in white, shot down amid the rubble of a ruined city. The official Vatican interpretation discussed with Sister Lucia before its publication was that it referred to the persecution of Christians in the 20th century and specifically to the 13th of May 1981 assassination attempt on the life of Saint John Paul II. Now, Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger, the future Pope, Benedict XVI was the prefect of the Congregation of the Doctrine of the Faith at that time of the third secrets of the publication of the third secret of Fatima in 2000. And presenting the secret and the interpretation to the press, he said the vision's purpose was not to show an irrevocably fixed future, but to mobilize the forces of change in the right direction. Francis here in Fatima is here for the first time in Fatima. It is his 19th foreign visit outside Italy. He arrived here on Friday afternoon, and soon after he arrived, he was received by the church and state dignitaries here, including the president of Portugal, Marcelo Rebelo de Sousa. He had a private talk with him at the airport, that is the Monte Real military air base where the Pope's plane landed Friday afternoon. Soon after that, the Pope left for Fatima, where he visited the chapel at the air base, and from there he boarded a helicopter where he landed in the stadium of Fatima. And from there he went up straight up to the sanctuary where he visited the chapel of the apparitions, where Our Lady had asked the children to build a church, to build a chapel. Chapel of the Apparitions, the Pope prayed and meditated silently, blessing the candles, and he also addressed the people there, and there was the recitation of the rosary in various languages. And this morning he had a meeting with the Prime Minister. And before the Mass, he visited the tombs of the three seers of Fatima before starting the Mass.
Amen.
The theme of this visit of Pope Francis to Fatima is With Mary, Pilgrim in Hope and in Peace. This is the sixth visit by a pope to Fatima. Before him, there were four others: Pope Paul VI, John Paul II, who made three visits, and Benedict and Pope Francis, one each. And today, at the Mass of the 100 years of the apparition of Our Blessed Mother to the three seers of Fatima, to the three seers of Fatima, he canonized Francisco and Jacinta, who died soon after the apparitions, and they became the youngest ever saints who were not martyred, with Jacinta becoming the youngest. When Mary first appeared to the three children, Lucia dos Santos was 10, Francisco was 9, and Jacinta Marto. And when Francisco died at the age of 10, and her sister Jacinta the following year at the age of 9.
Thank you.
guardemos silêncio por alguns momentos e permaneçamos em oração. Rimaniamo alcuni istanti in silenzio orante. Let's keep prayerful silence for some brief moments.
Oremos. Concedei, Senhor, que o sacramento que recebemos conduza à vida eterna aqueles que proclamam a Virgem Santa Maria, Mãe do vosso Filho e Mãe da Igreja. Por nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo, vosso Filho, que Deus convosco na unidade do Espírito Santo.
O Senhor Jesus, que recebemos na comunhão eucarística, alimento para a vida, continua presente no meio de nós, sobre o altar, no pão consagrado. E Ele fez-se peregrino no meio da humanidade e continua presente no sacramento da Eucaristia para alimentar a nossa esperança e nos fortalecer na construção da paz. Acolhamos o dom da Sua presença. Deixemo-nos envolver no seu olhar de ternura. Entreguemos confiadamente nas suas mãos a nossa vida e as nossas preces. Ele abençoa cada um de nós nos caminhos da nossa vida, manifestando particular amor por quem sofre. Adoremo-lo cantando como o anjo ensinou aos pastorinhos.
And now, at the end of the Mass, the third part, the adoration of the Most Blessed Sacrament and the blessing of the sick. The deacon has placed the Blessed Sacrament at the center of the altar. And the Pope is standing right in front of it. The entire assembly here, assembly of the faithful here at the shrine of Fatima in front of the Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary is in silent adoration and personal prayer. On the third and the final part of today's liturgy, which is the adoration of the Holy Eucharist and the blessing of the sick by Pope Francis.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas doentes, como dice en homilía, o Señor siempre nos precede. Cuando pasamos a través de alguna cruz, Él ya pasó antes.
And the Pope, Pope Francis, is now addressing the sick people with his message here. As I said in the homily, the Lord always goes before us, the Pope said. Whenever we experience a cross, He has already been there ahead of us. In His passion, He took upon Himself all our suffering. Jesus knows the meaning of sorrow and pain. He understands us, He comforts us, and He gives us strength, as He did to Saint Francisco Marto and Saint Jacinta, and to the saints of every time and place. I think of the Apostle Peter in chains in the prison of Jerusalem as the whole church prayed for him. The Lord comforted Peter. That is the Church's ministry. The Church asks the Lord to comfort the afflicted like yourselves, and He comforts you even in ways you cannot see. He comforts you in the depths of your hearts, and He comforts you with the gift of strength.
Tenemos Jesús escondido, ma presente en Eucaristía, como tenemos Jesús escondido, mas presente nas chagas dos nossos irmãos e irmãs doentes e atribulados. No altar adoramos a carne de Jesus. Neles encontramos as chagas de Jesus. O cristão adora Jesus. O cristão.
Dear pilgrims, we have before us Jesus hidden yet present in the Eucharist. Just as we have Jesus hidden yet present in the wounds of our brothers and sisters who are sick and suffering. On the altar we worship the flesh of Jesus. In these our brothers and sisters we encounter the wounds of Jesus. The Christian adores Jesus. The Christian seeks Jesus. The Christian can recognize the wounds of Jesus. Today the Virgin Mary asks all of us the same question that 100 years ago she asked the shepherd children. Do you want to offer yourselves to God? Their answer, yes, we do, makes us able to understand and imitate their lives. They lived life with its share of joy and suffering as an offering to the Lord.
Con un don, e dicei a Nossa Senhora como pastorinhos que vos quereis oferecer a Deus de todo o coração. non vos considereis apenas receptores de solidaridad caritativa, mas sentivos inseridos a pleno
título. I invite those of you who are sick to live your lives as a gift. Like the shepherd children, tell Our Lady that you want to offer yourselves to God with all your heart. Don't think of yourselves simply as the recipients of charitable solidarity, but feel that you share fully in the Church's life and mission. Your silent presence, which is more eloquent than a flood of words, your prayers, the daily offering of your sufferings, the daily offering of your sufferings in union with those of Jesus crucified for the salvation of the world, the patient and even joyful acceptance of your condition. All these are a spiritual resource, an asset to every Christian community. Do not be ashamed of being a precious treasure of the Church.
Os vossos sufrimentos, o vosso cansaço. Contai con a oração da igreja.
Jesus will pass close to you in the Blessed Sacrament as a sign of his closeness and love for you. Entrust to him your sorrows, your sufferings, all your weariness. Count on the prayer of the Church, which from every corner of the world rises up to heaven for you and with you. God is a Father, and he will never forget you, the Pope said. Taken up the monstrance with the Holy Eucharist there. He will bless all the sick persons present there who have come for this occasion, the 100th anniversary of the Fatima apparitions. The sick have been placed, accommodated in a special area next to the sanctuary.
Como os doentes de outrora, invoquemos a misericórdia do Senhor e dizemos, Senhor, tende compaixão de mim. Jesus, filho de David, tende misericórdia de mim. Jesus, filho de David, tende misericórdia de mim. Senhor, dizei uma só palavra e eu serei curado. Senhor, aquele a quem amais está doente. Senhor, socorrei-me que pereço. Senhor, se quiserdes, podeis curar-me. Senhor, eu creio, mas aumentai a minha fé. Professemos a nossa fé em Jesus Cristo, verdadeiramente presente no sacramento da Eucaristia. Senhor, nós cremos em vós. Senhor, nós esperamos em vós. Senhor, nós vos amamos. Senhor, nós vos adoramos. Ó Jesus, vós sois o Filho de Deus vivo. Senhor, vós sois o pão descido do céu. Ó Jesus, o vosso corpo é verdadeira comida. Ó Jesus, o vosso sangue é verdadeira bebida. Cantemos a Jesus, presença de Deus entre nós.
Well, the theme of the Pope's visit to Fatima here, Pope Francis' visit to Fatima, is with Mary, pilgrim in hope and in peace, and that he beautifully brought out in his homily, which was actually on the themes of hope and peace.
He quoted the children and said, Our Lady foretold and warned about the way of life that is godless and indeed profanes God and his creatures. Such a life frequently proposed and imposed risks leading to hell. And Mary came to remind that God's light dwells within us and protects us. And he said that this is very true of Fatima. Fatima is more than anything else, this mantle of light that protects us here as in almost no other place on earth. We have a mother, the Pope says, and he urged Christians to cling to her like children. We live in hope that rests on Jesus. Let us fix our hope on that humanity seated in heaven at the right hand of the Father, Jesus Christ. May this hope, the Pope said, guide our lives. It is a hope that sustains us always to our dying breath. And then he admitted I could not fail to come here to venerate the Virgin Mary and to entrust to her all her sons and daughters under her mantle. They are not lost, the Pope said. From our embrace will come the hope and peace that they require and that I implore for all my brothers and sisters in baptism and in our human family, especially the sick and the disabled, prisoners and unemployed, the poor and the abandoned. The Pope reminded Christians that God created us to be a source of hope for others, a true and attainable hope in accordance with each person's state of life.
Na certeza de que Ele nos olha com amor, que escuta e acolhe a nossa oração.
In asking and demanding of each of us the fulfillment of the duties of our proper state, God effects a general mobilization against the indifference that chills the heart and worsens our myopia. The Pope reminded in his homily that life can survive only because of the generosity of other lives.
Oremos. Señor Jesús Cristo, que en este admirável sacramento nos dejastes un memorial da vossa paixão, concedei-nos a graça de venerar de tal modo os mistérios do vosso corpo e sangue, que sintamos continuamente os frutos da vossa redenção. Vós que sois Deus como Pai, na unidade do Espírito Santo.
The Pope prayed, Lord Jesus Christ, that in this marvelous sacrament you have left us the memorial of your passion, grant us the grace to venerate the mysteries of your body and blood in a way that we may continually feel the fruits of your redemption.
Bendito seja Deus, bendito o seu santo nome, bendito Jesus Cristo, verdadeiro Deus e verdadeiro homem, bendito o nome de Jesus, bendito o seu sacratíssimo coração, bendito o seu preciosíssimo sangue, bendito Jesus no santíssimo sacramento do altar, bendito o Espírito Santo Paráclito, bendita a excelsa Mãe de Deus, Maria Santíssima, bendita a sua santa e imaculada Conceição. Bendita a sua gloriosa Assunção. Bendito o nome de Maria, Virgem e Mãe. Bendito São José, seu castíssimo esposo. Bendito Deus nos seus anjos e nos seus santos.
Minha alma proclama a grandeza do Senhor e o meu espírito exulta de alegria em Deus meu Salvador.
And now we have Bishop Antonio Marto of Leiria Fatima with his vote of thanks to the Pope for having come. to commemorate the 100 years of the Fatima apparitions. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit is exalted in God my Savior. Bishop Martel said, I borrowed the words of the song of the Virgin Mary, the canticle of the Virgin Mary, to express the sentiments of joy, the feelings that fill our hearts for the gift of your presence among us, but especially to be able to sing with you the mercy of the Lord that echoed here 100 years ago in the message of Our Lady, brighter than the sun, addressed to all mankind. With you we wish to exclaim, Blessed be God, rich in mercy, for the great love with which he has loved us.
Salve, Santo Padre, bem-vindo a Fátima. Estais em vossa casa.
It's an immense joy to welcome you to the sanctuary, Holy Father, where your maternal heart of Portugal, where the maternal heart of Portugal is beating. Welcome, Holy Father, welcome to Fátima, you are at home.
Trago-vos o abraço e o afeto de todo o povo católico de Portugal, com seu episcopado, todo o seu episcopado aqui presente.
In this brief greeting, I bring you the embrace and affection of all the Catholic people of Portugal and of many goodwill men and women who love you well. Everyone has their own fixed. Everyone has their eyes fixed on Pope Francis as a prophetic voice clearly heard on the stage of the world, full of dangers and fears, and is able to break down walls of separation, to build bridges of encounter among individuals and peoples.
Vós, capaz de abater muros de separação, de lançar pontes de encontro entre os homens e os povos, de ser a voz dos sem voz, os pobres.
To build bridges of encounter among individuals and peoples, to be the voice of the voiceless, the poor, the suffering, and the rejected.
De levar a alegria do Evangelho a todas as criaturas sem exclusão de ninguém.
To open paths of hope and peace, to bring the joy and love of God, the joy of the gospel, to every creature in whatever condition. Thank you for your testimony, Holy Father, who touches us so deeply.
Quero agradecer-vos de modo particular terdes vindo até nós como peregrino, segundo o lema da vossa visita, com Maria, peregrino na esperança e na paz. Aqui estás conosco, peregrino entre os peregrinos vindos de todo o mundo, nesta Assembleia da Igreja Peregrina, Igreja Viva, Santa e Pecadora, para celebrar a ação de graças pelo centenário das aparições da Virgem Maria e pela sua mensagem de misericórdia, de esperança e de paz.
We want to thank you especially for having come among us as a pilgrim, according to the motto of your visit, with Mary, pilgrim in hope and peace. And you are here with us, pilgrims among pilgrims from all over the world, in this gathering of the Pilgrim Church, of the Living Church, both holy and sinful, in order to celebrate the thanksgiving for the centenary of the apparitions of the Virgin Mary and for her message of grace, mercy and peace, which set out from here 100 years ago. To all over the world through the three shepherd children of Fátima,
intercessores afetuosos pelo Santo Padre. Santo Padre, estão hoje aqui muitos pequenitos, muitos meninos e meninas que vieram celebrar estes seus companheiros lá no céu e vieram ver-vos e saudar-vos. Peço-vos permissão de, em vosso nome, dirigir, enviar uma carícia aos pequeninos. Caros amiguitos e amiguitas, Papa Francisco envia-vos uma carícia cheia de ternura
e uma bênção especial para que sejais sempre meninos e meninas alegres e felizes como Francisco e Jacinta. Queremos agradecer ainda ao Senhor nosso Deus as pequenas e grandes maravilhas de graça que Ele realizou em Maria e através da sua mensagem ao longo destes 100 anos, em tantas histórias de peregrinos anónimos, mas devotos, em frutos invisíveis aos olhos humanos de conversão, de reconciliação, de comunhão, de justiça, de paz, de santidade. Hoje é o momento mais alto da celebração do centenário das aparições. Um dia histórico e memorável. Um dia cheio de beleza. Uma beleza que vós, Santo Padre, podeis de algum modo ver na beleza do colorido desta paisagem humana da imensidão de peregrinos que aqui estão. Santo Padre, estaremos sempre unidos a vós, como filhos reconhecidos a um Pai que nos visita com a sua ternura e o seu sorriso e nos encoraja a viver mais intensamente e com mais entusiasmo como discípulos de Jesus, ao jeito de Maria, Mãe de Jesus e Nossa Mãe. A intercessão materna de Nossa Senhora de Fátima e dos Santos Francisco e Jacinta Marto, confiamos a vossa pessoa, para que o Senhor vos dê saúde, fortaleza, coragem e fecundidade no vosso ministério apostólico, ao serviço da Igreja em saída e ao serviço da esperança e da paz no nosso mundo. Muito obrigado, Santo Padre.
With the intercession of Our Lady of Fatima and Saints Francis and Jacinta Marto, we entrust you to the Lord to give you strength, courage, and fruitfulness in your apostolic ministry at the service of the outgoing Church, meeting the human peripheries and peace service in the world. Bishop Antonio Marto of Leiria and Fatima, they are showing to the people the gift that Pope Francis brought and gave to the sanctuary of Fatima, a chalice and a chasuble. And with that, we come to the end of this centenary celebration of the Fatima apparitions with a Mass by Pope Francis here in the sanctuary of Fatima.
We are coming to the end of this live coverage of the Pope's Mass at the Marian Shrine of Fatima in Portugal in commemoration of the 100 years of the apparition of the Blessed Virgin Mary to Lucia dos Santos and her cousins Francisco and Jacinta Marto. During this Mass, the Pope declared Francisco and Jacinta saints. Hence, they are the Church's newest as well as the youngest non-martyr child saints, with their feast falling on February 20. At the end of the Mass, the Pope also blessed the sick during an adoration of the Holy Eucharist. With that, we conclude this live coverage. Thanks to all our viewers and listeners who joined us on television and the radio on CBS News, Shalom World TV, Radio Maria, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Telecare TV, Net TV, Catholic TV, and also on the Vatican's YouTube channel.
Thank you.
Goodbye from me, Sister Kamala and AC, and Robin Gomes, here from the studio of Vatican Radio in Fatima, Portugal. Laudetur Jesus Christus.
Caros peregrinos, o Santo Padre, o Papa Francisco, irá ainda passar pelo recinto de oração. Podemos ainda aguardar esse momento em que o Santo Padre vai despedir-se de nós aqui no recinto, passando no meio desta Assembleia.
Oh. Caros peregrinos, Sua Santidade o Papa Francisco, na saída deste santuário, vai agora atravessar o recinto de oração. Agradecendo a sua presença entre nós nesta peregrinação, na celebração do centenário das aparições de Nossa Senhora aqui em Fátima e a canonização dos pastorinhos, os santos Francisco e Jacinta Marto, cantemos com alegria, louvando o Senhor.
Thank you.